HK Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. HK Infosys supports 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus. One-time pay, lifetime access to live classes and videos. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For free demo class, visit h2kinfosys.com.
Hello everyone and welcome to this series on Selenium interview questions and answers by H2K Infosys. I am Sonal Mittal and we will be discussing the top Selenium interview questions that will be helpful for freshers as well as testing professionals. Now, let us look at the most frequently asked questions during interviews. Now, this is our today's question, which is, what are the different types of weights supported by Selenium? Guys, weights play a very important role in executing Selenium test scripts. We use Selenium to test different elements on the web pages, right? So when a page is loaded by the browser, the elements which we want to interact with, the elements on which we want to perform action on, like clicking, double click, right click, enter the text, fetch the text, or fetch the current URL. So such elements may load at different time intervals, correct? So if the tool is not able to locate those elements on the web page, is not able to find such element, that particular element on the web page, then our script will fail with an exception as no such element found or with an exception as no element visible. So in order to resolve such issues in our test scripts, we can use weights in Selenium. Guys, Selenium supports two types of weights. Those are implicit weights and explicit weights. In an interview, when you are asked about weights, guys, please first answer the two types of weights and then go ahead and explain further about implicit weight with its syntax. Then explain about explicit weight and its syntax. Let us look at implicit weight first and then we will look at explicit weight. Implicit weights in Selenium. Implicit weights are simple and straightforward used in Selenium test scripts. Whenever an implicit weight is applied in a Selenium test script, the web driver waits for a certain amount of time before it throws a no such element found exception. The syntax for implicit wait is one line. It makes use of implicitly wait method, which is applied over timeouts method. Okay. It makes use of, there are two parameters that we pass to implicitly wait method. The first parameter is timeout, which requires an integer value and it determines the total amount of time the tool will wait. The second parameter is time unit, which determines the unit of time. Here I have given 10 as the total amount of time for the tool to wait and it is in seconds. You can also give milliseconds. So the tool is going to wait for 10 seconds, okay, before it executes the next step. Let us quickly look at a test script which is implementing implicit wait. Here is a quick script which I have written for you guys. I'm first opening the Chrome browser. I'm maximizing the browser window and I'm trying to load H2K Infosys website using the get method. When the browser is loading the web pages or the web page is opening or loading all the web elements, I'm asking the tool to meanwhile wait for 10 seconds. That is implicitly wait for 10 seconds. I hope implicit wait is clear now. This is how you can answer in your interview, explaining about the definition of implicit wait and then an example if required. Now let us look at explicit wait. In case of explicit wait, guys, we make use of two things, that is expected conditions and maximum time. Explicit wait, guys, is an intelligent kind of wait. It will be applied for a specific element. This wait is a dynamic wait for any particular element on a web page. Now we declare two details in explicit wait, as I mentioned earlier. That is, asking the web driver to wait for certain condition, certain expected conditions. If the condition is satisfied and the element is visible, then the tool will go ahead and execute the next step. Or we are asking the tool to wait for maximum time. Meanwhile, the condition should be satisfied and the element should be available on the web page to perform an action on. And then the tool will go ahead and execute the next step. If the time is maximum time has exceeded and the condition is not satisfied, that is the element is not visible, then we will get an exception, or the script will fail with an exception as element not visible or element not found, or in the exception related to the condition here. So remember, in explicit wait, we make use of certain conditions, expected conditions, and maximum time. We make use of until method and the class expected conditions in explicit wait. Let's first look at a quick script, and then we will see the time that we can give here. So here is this quick test script that I have written for explicit wait. We are opening the Chrome browser here, and we are maximizing the browser, and then we are opening the H2K Infosys web page on the Chrome browser, and then I'm trying to locate an element which is a search box on H2K Infosys website. I'm storing the location of this web element in a web element called E. Now I'm going to specifically apply an explicit wait. As I told you, explicit waits are applied for particular element or specific element. So here the element on which we are going to apply explicit wait is E, and we are giving a condition that the element should be visible and the maximum amount of time the tool has to wait is 5 seconds. Now here the maximum or the recommended amount of time should be 20 seconds, not more than that, otherwise the total time for executing the script will increase. Okay, now here we have a list of expected conditions which the testers can use based on the element they are working with. Okay, so let me show you the different expected conditions which you can also use in your interviews if they ask. Okay, so let us look at the different conditions that we have. So for here, this is the element that we are working with, and we are applying a explicit wait on that particular element. Okay. I am declaring an object. Okay, we are creating a reference for our driver, and we are asking the tool to wait for 5 seconds. You can give 10 seconds also. By default, it takes seconds as a time unit. Then we are calling the method until. I hope it is more visible to you now. We are calling the method until, and then calling the class expected conditions dot. You will get the list of all the expected conditions. Like if you are working with the elements to be clickable, if it is a button or any link which is to be clicked on, you can make use of this condition, elements to be clickable. If you are selecting from a drop down, you can use elements to be selected. If you are waiting for an element to be visible, which is most frequently used, we can make use of visibility of all elements, visibility of a particular element which we are using. Okay, and here you can provide the location of the element that you are asking the tool to wait for. I hope now in any time in the interview, if you are asked about waits, you should be able to answer very perfectly about the different waits times that are supported in Selenium. Thank you.
H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys supports 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus. One-time pay, lifetime access to live classes and videos. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For free demo class, visit h2kinfosys.com.